Dear student, today we are going to discuss about the Coulomb's law in vector form. Dear student, previously we have seen here the statement of the Coulomb's law, and in that we have seen the Coulomb's law is force of attraction or the repulsion between the two charges is given by the F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 into q2 upon r square. In this formula, the q1 and q2 are the charges which are separated by the distance of r between them. If the charges are like, they repel to one another. If the charges are unlike, they attract to one another. We have seen this in the previous video. But in this topic, we have to see the Coulomb's law in a vector form. So here are the two charges. This is the charge q1, which is placed at the point A. Another charge q2, which is placed at the point B. So these are the charges A and B. Point ko maine kya kiya hai, do charges ko place kiya. This is q1, this is q2. Both the charges having the like nature, plus and plus. So these charges repel to one another. The distance of the charges from the O, O is the origin of the coordinate system, means distance OA is equal to R1, that is the vector R1, and the distance of the second charge which is placed at the point B is OB, given by the vector R2. And distance between the two charges A and B, means here the Q1 and Q2, is R12. R12 denotes here the distance between the charge first and second, R12. But here, according to the Coulomb's law, charge Q1 exert a force of repulsion on the charge Q2. Similarly, the Q2 exert a force of repulsion on the charge Q1. So here, the force of repulsion exerted on the second charge by the first charge is given by the F21. Means here, F21 means the force on the second charge by the first charge. F21 means here, the force on the second charge by the first charge is equal to, according to Coulomb's law, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r12 mod of r12, means here magnitude is taken of the distance between the two charges, r12 square into, ab isse kya hoga, फोर्स कहाँ पर लग रहा है, सेकंड चार्ज पर लग रहा है, यहाँ पर लग रहा है, मीन्स दिस इज द फोर्स एफ टू वन. बट इन दिस डायरेक्शन क्या होगा, आपका यूनिट वेक्टर भी होगा. यूनिट वेक्टर का डायरेक्शन कहाँ से कहाँ होगा, पहले चार्ज से लेके दूसरे चार्ज तक, मीन्स यहाँ पे होगा आर वन टू यूनिट वेक्टर, दैट आई हैव रिटन इन द रेड इंक पेन. सो आर वन टू इज द यूनिट वेक्टर इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ चार्ज क्यू वन टू क्यू टू, मीन्स फ्रॉम ए टू बी. So here R12 is the unit vector and direction of the force is from A to B, because here F21 is the force of repulsion on the second charge by the first charge. So here F21 is given by the 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R12 square into unit vector R12. Here unit vector indicates that the vector is directed from first charge to second charge. But similarly, this charge experiences a force of repulsion by this charge, means force of repulsion on the first charge by the second charge is given by the F12, force on the first charge by the second charge. So here, this is the force on the first charge by the second charge. Direction of the force from point B to A, means from charge Q2 to Q1. So again here is the unit vector, that unit vector is given by कहाँ से कहाँ तक, R21, means second charge से first charge तक, means R21 is the unit vector in the direction of the F12. So here again the force of repulsion on the first charge by the second is given by the same formula, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r12 square into r21. Here is the unit vector r21. But here it is important to note here that the direction of the unit vector r21 and unit vector r12 are opposite to one another. Means they are directed opposite to one another. One of the vector r12 is directed towards the right hand side and this directed towards the left hand side. Means here r12 is equal to the minus of r21. Therefore here we have seen r12 is equal to minus of r21. Therefore here ये force का भी direction क्या होगा? Opposite ही होगा. Therefore यहाँ पे f21 is equal to minus of f12. Thus the two charges experience a force of कितना? Force of attraction or the repulsion of the two equal magnitude and opposite in direction. These two forces form a action reaction pair. So this is called as the Coulomb's law in the vector form. Yala kay manaycho Coulomb's law in the vector form. Now next topic is the principle of superposition of the charges. So principle of the superposition of charges means in the previous video we have seen that when the charges are transferred from one part of the body to the another part of the body, the total charges will be equal to the क्या होगा transfer कितना किया और कितना gain किया means total number of the charges must be the same, must be the equal. Means none of the charges created not destroyed but charge can be transferred from one system to another system, one part of the system to the another part of the system. Means here the total number of the charges remains constant or conserved. So this is the principle of the superposition of the charges. Means in the previous video we have seen that when the glass rod is rubbed with the fur, then the charges are transferred from the glass rod to the fur or the fur to the glass rod. So there is the only transfer of the charges, but here charge cannot be newly generated, newly created, not destroyed, but it is only transfer from one part to another part of the system. So here the total number of the charges remains constant. This is called as the what? Principle of superposition of charges. But this is for the two body system. But here if we consider the multiple charges having the value q1, q2, q3, q4 and so on, and therefore here means here consider a number of charges q1, q2, q3 situated at the point of a1, a2, a3 of the system, then each and every charge experience or exert a force of attraction or the repulsion on another. So here, so please observe this figure. Here a1 is the point at which the charge q1 is placed. So q1 is the charge which is placed at the point a1. Here a2 is the point, here the charge q2 is placed. Another a3 is the point at which the charge a3 is placed, q3 is placed. At the point a4, charge q4. At a5 point, charge q5 is placed. So here each and every charge q1, q2, q1, q3, q1, q4, q1, q5 means here experience or exert a force on the another charge. Similarly here charge a2 and a3 means charge q1, q2. Similarly charge q2, q3, q3, q4, q4, q5 exert a force or experience a force of attraction or the repulsion depending on the nature of the charges. So here for the first means here suppose here we are going to consider here the charge q1 and q2. Having the distance between them is r12. R12 denotes here the distance between the two charges. So here is the force on the first charge by the second charge is given by the f12. The direction of the force is from charge q2 to q1. Unit vector is from q2 to q1. Therefore here the force of attraction or repulsion is given by the F1 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 upon r12 and unit vector. Similarly here the charge q3 exert a force of repulsion on the charge q1. Again here F kaun sa lagega dono ke beech ka hai F13. F13 again is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q3 upon r13 square into unit vector.
अगेन हियर द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द फर्स्ट चार्ज एंड द फोर्थ चार्ज गिवन बाय एफ वन फोर मीन्स हियर अगेन वन अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो क्यू वन क्यू फोर अपॉन आर वन फोर स्क्वायर एंड यूनिट वेक्टर लाइक दिस. सो हियर टोटल फोर्स एक्सर्टेड ऑन द चार्ज क्यू वन टोटल फोर्सेस एक्सर्टेड बाय द चार्ज क्यू टू क्यू थ्री क्यू फोर क्यू फाइव ऑन द फर्स्ट चार्ज इज गिवन बाय द वेक्टर सम. देयरफॉर हियर द टोटल फोर्स इज इक्वल टू दैट इज इक्वल टू एफ वन टू प्लस एफ वन थ्री प्लस एफ वन फोर प्लस एफ वन फाइव एंड सो ऑन. बट इन ईच फार्मूली हियर इज द कॉमन टर्म वन अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो दैट वन अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो कैन बी टेकन आउट ऑफ द ब्रैकेट. ओनली द टर्म रिमेन्स इन द ब्रैकेट इज क्यू वन क्यू टू अपॉन आर वन टू स्क्वेयर प्लस क्यू वन क्यू थ्री आर थ्री वन और आर वन थ्री स्क्वेयर नेक्स्ट क्यू वन क्यू फोर आर वन फोर स्क्वेयर. सो दिस इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ द फोर्स ऑन द चार्ज फर्स्ट. सो हियर मीन्स हियर द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन स्टेट दैट द टोटल फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द चार्जेस इज इक्वल टू द वेक्टर सम ऑफ द फोर्सेस एक्सर्टेड बाय द ईच एंड एवरी चार्ज इन द सिस्टम. सो हियर द साइन ऑफ द प्लस इज डिनोटेड बाय द समेशन. देयरफॉर हियर फोर्स एट द टेस्ट चार्ज इज एफ वन प्लस एफ टू प्लस एफ थ्री प्लस एफ एन. देयरफॉर समेशन ऑफ एफ एन इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो समेशन क्यू जीरो क्यू एन अपॉन आर एन. दिस इज द नोटेशन फॉर द एन नंबर ऑफ द चार्जेस. सो हियर टोटल फोर्स इज गिवन बाय द वन अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो समेशन ऑफ क्यू आई क्यू जे आर आई जे आर एन यूनिट वेक्टर. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपर पोजिशन ऑफ द चार्जेस. सो डियर स्टूडेंट यू मस्ट टू रीड द पेज नंबर 194 एंड इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी देन प्लीज आस्क मी. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग वीडियो.